You're listening to iLive Radio, changing the way you listen to radio. iLive Radio.
Long overdue, but glad to be back. We are doing another segment of Pattern Select. And this is a Pattern Select segment that I've been waiting a long while to do. We've got the brother Sada in the building. And man, I usually have story time, but I don't know if I really got much story time for this one. I still haven't seen him play live. I haven't got to see him at a build session or at any of Ann Zola's functions, but I've heard your beats and I've stalked your pages and I've stalked your art, and knowing who you are affiliated with and associate yourself with has just made me want to listen to you even more and what it is that you bring to the table. So I'm glad I have you in here today, my brother. Thank you so much for coming through. We've got the brother that is from Scarborough, a home of mine and a place that's dear to my heart. Tell everybody about who you are and how you came about doing your thing.
I'm Julian. It's my real name. Oh, my Sada, S-A-D-A. I was raised in Scarborough. I started making beats in high school, maybe about grade 11. I've been doing it. I was in grade 11 all the way up until now. I had sometimes. I've had a couple hiatuses from doing it. But I'm here now. I've built up a lot of connections in the last few years. Max Melanin being one of them.
Shout out to Max.
And Nate, the guy that's actually playing the strings and singing on this backing track. I really mess with those guys a lot, a whole lot.
So how many years solid would you say that it's been for you at this point?
Well, in the type of music that I've been doing, I would say I've been figuring my way through it in the last 2 years. And in the last 2 years is where people start to pick up on me. I wouldn't say I have a huge buzz, but from where I was 3 years ago till now, people have definitely been listening to an extent.
Dope. Yeah. Now, Sada, like I said, you're cut from a certain type of cloth in this city when it comes to beats. A cloth that, for me, personally, has been extremely refreshing and something that I've been actually craving to see younger cats like yourself doing in the industry again. It's brought back a sense of pride and joy to the music again that comes out of this city.
Yeah.
What is it that inspires you guys to create the sound that you guys create right now in such a climate that is very, let's be honest, it's very trap focused.
Yeah.
It's very, it's different.
Definitely.
What is it that makes you guys stick to what it is that you stick to and believe in it so much that you keep creating it within the climate that you're in?
Yeah, well, I feel like with internet now, it's like shortened time and space. So even though like what's on the surface, what you see on the surface is a lot of trap, you can still find artists that are doing things that are, I would say, organic. So, like for example, my relationship with Max, I've only known him for about a year now. But the way I found him was through Nate, who is based out in Brooklyn, and he's born in New Jersey. So funny thing was, I was looking through his page. He reached out to me, and I scrolled his likes, and I saw that he commented on this guy Max Melanin's page, which he so happened to live down the street from me. So it's just like it's like a coincidence in a sense. Like, how is it I'm finding out about this guy that lives down the street from me from a guy that lives in a whole other country?
It's amazing how the internet works.
It's amazing.
Yeah, incredible. See, and I love what you said about, and you used a key word, or organic, you know. Something that a lot of people I find shy away from, you know, in this internet age of music and quick access to music and just being able to kind of get yourself out there without much trouble, without much pushback.
Yeah.
You know, people tend to stray away a lot from that very core soulful aspect of creating art that you guys do so well.
Yeah.
Which is what impresses me so much about what you guys do, and the fact that that's something that is so dear to you guys, and it's apparent in your music.
Definitely.
What about the soul aspect of things moves you the most to want to make sure that that element is always there within your sound?
Well, I feel like with lo-fi and like real hip-hop, not trap, it's like everything is so natural. It relies on you being so natural, like from the feel of the drum to how you chop your samples. Like, there's more of an identity in each irrespective artist, I would say.
Right.
So, I mean, I could tell a Max Melody beat from a Knowledge beat.
Right.
Right? So I feel like there's just more identity
in the soul.
Yeah.
So that being said, what's the process like for you right now with regards to how you start creating? What things move you to create a certain type of beat and give it the feel that you give?
It's very sporadic. I could admit that in the last few months I haven't been creating as much, but when I'm in a mood to create, it's usually off being around people who are in a cycle of creating. Mm-hmm. So when me, Max, and they linked up, that was like one of the most productive
periods
of, I'd say, my career. Just because we're on the same wavelength, right? Just other people really drive me the most, I would say.
You've been extremely busy lately. I mean, anybody who follows you on social media knows that you've been doing a ton of shows lately.
Yeah.
I mean, the pace has really picked up for you.
Mm-hmm.
How are you finding, you know, this new wave of just, you know, demand? You know, let's call it what it is. It's a demand right now. People are really recognizing your sound. People are wanting to hear more of it. How are you balancing the demand of you performing, but also the creative process as well? How are you finding that being challenging, or?
I find it very challenging right now. Like for this week, for example, is probably my busiest week in like probably ever, really, in the amount of gigs. I have a couple days where I'm doing 2 gigs in a day. So it's getting kind of hard to find time to create, but every opportunity I get, I'll try.
Mm-hmm.
But also, like, the time in between, it takes away from your drive and your inspiration. If I'm DJing for, like, if I'm doing 4 gigs a week, then it's kind of hard for me to jump back into it.
Right.
And find the same thing from the last time I was productive.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. So that's the balancing act that you're trying to manage right now.
Yes, definitely.
Okay.
Definitely.
So, project wise, what's on the horizon for people project wise with regards to your work at this point, and what can people get their hands on right now? I know it's a little bit difficult right now for people to get certain things from the past from you, but what's coming up that they can look forward to?
I've worked with Tay Gyra. He's a buddy of mine from Star World, ever since I can remember. So he's been rapping for a few years now. And really, I just want to work with more rappers.
Yeah.
I want to collab. Yeah.
Yeah. The reason why I'm going to ask you this question is because, I'm finding right now, especially for me, from a listener's perspective, I'm not really hearing much rappers right now that I really want to listen to.
Yeah.
And I'm not saying that there's MCs out there that aren't doing dope things, but I'm saying in comparison to the amount of producers that are speaking with sounds right now so eloquently,
yeah,
I would rather listen to instrumental music right now than listen to anybody rapping on beats.
Exactly.
How are you finding that right now? Being an instrumental artist yourself, how are you finding that aspect of things right now in the game?
Yeah, it's interesting because I recently came across a tweet from, I think it was Sunny Digital.
Yeah.
He mentioned about how none of the trap producers won any Grammys this year.
Mm-hmm.
But it kind of made a buzz on Twitter from a lot of makers and producers. Because their claim was about the producer's aspect was that they really control what's going on in the sound. The producers.
Yeah.
So I feel like not enough credit is given to the producers in this era, especially where music's at now. Also with, like,
do you think he was taking a shot at him, a shot at trap producers though, in that tweet, or was he saying that they should have won awards this
they
year?
Should have won awards. Yeah, I feel like they should have. I mean, you guys,
which trap producers do you think should have won awards this year?
I personally feel like 1985 should have won some awards.
Yeah.
With the work he did with Drake, even Murder, like a lot of Eagles kill the streams this year.
Yeah.
Yeah, they still, I feel like they should have won something. There should be an award for that.
For something.
Yeah,
production
and
wise. Yeah, I mean, don't get me wrong. I mean, you know, a lot of those beats are dope. You know what
yeah.
I mean? Like you hear them by themselves, and they're dope.
Yeah.
That's the thing for me. The monotony is what kills it, because you know you could line up. I don't know. I could blindfold myself and line up 11 trap producers, and I wouldn't be able to tell you who was who.
Exactly. Yeah.
That's just me. I mean, I you know, shoot
it's
me
totally
for this,
true.
But you know, that's just me personally. I can't tell the difference, but. You beside Max, beside Knowledge, beside Obla, beside, and I can pinpoint the sound,
yeah.
I can pinpoint the authenticity and feel of each and every single one of you.
Yeah.
To me, that speaks more than what these guys are doing, right? So, I guess perspective is everything, but I'll probably catch flack on the internet for this one.
Well, like, I see a lot. I see both sides of the spectrum because. When I'm out DJing, I'm not playing like 90 BPM
right.
hip-hop, right? It's mostly...
You're playing the trap stuff.
The primes are trap, yeah.
Yeah, you know, the 120 BPMs and... Yeah.
Yeah, the 140.
Yeah.
But funny, like, with Playboi Carti's most recent album, like, I'm starting to see that the tempos are going up.
Right.
So I'm hoping that in the next few years that boom bap feel can come back.
Yeah. They say everything goes 360 in full circle. Who knows?
Yeah.
Who knows? I just feel like right now there's a little bit of a resurgence in the sound.
Mm-hmm.
And like you said, that organic feel is starting to come back a bit now. People are starting to kind of take heed to certain things again. You know, for instance, look at Jay-Z's last album. You know what I mean? You look at No ID, who's been around for, you know, 20 some odd years. And sticking to what it is that he does and still able to pull out an album that's now gone and sold millions of records, you know, and Jay-Z sounds flawless on it, you know what I mean? It still goes to show that sound is still has a place, and, you know, we can't give up hope, you know, in it coming back around. So you may be right. It may come right back around, you know? Lots of instrumental projects coming out, as you know, of course. A lot of producers just pumping out things on a weekly basis. There's constantly a lot of music. What about instrumental projects for you outside of working with other artists?
Really, I'm just trying to compile as many beats as I can to work with artists. Not really in the equation right now to release a project. I kind of like the feeling right now, just like collabing.
Right.
With rappers, I mean, I feel like it makes my music come to life, and it gives it a different purpose.
Anything outside of hip hop that you may be delving in? I know a lot of guys are trying some different things right now, which is so dope and refreshing. Like, you know, we got Astro, who's doing some house. Max even doing some house right now, which is really dope on the lo-fi end of things, and really bringing a different kind of an element to the music itself that a lot of people are enjoying. What about you? Are you delving into anything different or trying anything different?
I always love like dance dance music. So like Neymar, Jersey Club.
Right.
I make this stuff too, but like if you check, I was going through all my project files today and found a lot of like Jersey Club tracks. I love that stuff. Really, I do. Yeah, I have a lot on my computer. Yeah.
So what are you using right now? What tools, the trade, are in your toolbox that you your go to right now?
Ableton. Just because you can stack things on Ableton, and like you can save presets. And just the workflow. I mean, I went through Reason. I started with Reason. I went to Logic. Ableton looked like a science experiment at first, but once you figure out everything, you're fast. Yeah.
I love Ableton myself. Definitely what I, you know, that was the, when I kind of switched over to the software aspect of things, you know, moving from hardware, that's what I sell now. I just felt like it was home, you know what I mean? It felt like you could make it whatever machine it was that you were using prior, and that was dope about it for me. So.
Yeah, the emulation.
Yes.
Yeah.
Amazing. You know, you make it feel like the NPC, and, you know, you can kind of tailor it to what you want, which is amazing. So, I don't know, man. You got a lot of time. You got like 45 minutes to rock out. Tell everybody your social media. Where can they find your music? Where can they find your stuff?
My SoundCloud is Sada. So SoundCloud/Sada. My Instagram is AKASATA. My Twitter is Jules Posadas.
You can check Sada out on all that social media, fellas and ladies. This guy's got killer beats, man, and definitely somebody to keep an eye out for the future. Keep an eye on him. He is amazing. He's going to give you 45 minutes of music right now. So let's get into it. We've got a set from the brother Sada. He's going to rock out for us. iLive Radio, Sounds in the Hereafter, and this is a Pattern Select segment. What are we on? Number five, Jay? We're moving through. Getting through this. So, is it six? Oh, dope, man. We've been doing this longer than we thought, man. That's good. Thank you for the support. We love y'all. Sounds in the Hereafter. Let's do this, Sada.
today, you know what I mean? It taught me, it's like school of hard knocks, that's what some people call it. It's just real life, you know what I mean? I made it to be 20, so that means something. I'm supposed to do something, you know what I mean? I started making music when I was like 9. That's when I was really into the music. And I knew that was the music of the future. That was the music, that was the true new music, you know what I mean? A lot of people wasn't into rap in the early 80s. They didn't believe it would go as far as it's gone. Now it's the number one sound in the world, you know what I'm saying? Always has been, but now everybody else realized that. But I've been into this since I was like 9 years old, writing rhymes like 12. Before that, it was just freestyle. I mean, everybody grow up and into New York people make records. There's people right now that's nice at what they do, but situations they have, they will never see anybody that could put them onto a record. I don't believe in itself as much. But everybody that's born in the town, I just represent everybody that's born in a certain town.
Bye. Now, have to say.
Can't lose.
For acceptance, I'm just searching for repentance, cause I've done a lot of sinning on my way to the top. I know niggas wanna rob me of the jewels I got, but they can't take away the music or the jewels I drop. Some people change for the better, others never make the effort. Wish for silence when I rest up from the garden I am next up. Opportunity never blessed us when necessary. Nana's presence share my safety when the shit got scary. Stress on my face cause nothing ever goes as planned. Paper to chase, that shit always gets out of hand. When in life that's so crazy, no time for self getting lazy. I'm running low on money, they skipping out on my payments. And I need that, fuck your negative feedback. All these drugs around me, I'm praying that I don't relapse. Just praying that I don't relapse, bro. I rose from the concrete, the jungle keep you humble, fall asleep on my mind weak. I can't live my life punching in on that time sheet, wishing for the day that I awake and I find peace. Save my soul, save my soul. I just wanna save my soul,
yeah, yeah.
Save my soul.
Whoa, whoa, yeah. Oh, oh, oh.
Never sold my soul for no gold. Never told on my bro. Told a lie to a hoe. That's the code, I suppose. Living reckless, bit till I'm breathless, just to leave you the same way. At times I question if I make it out this hell I'm living. I'm trying to stop spending, I pray to the Lord, but I can't stop sinning. Hope you forgive me for my wrongdoing. My mama stressed, she just wanna know what her son doing. Many nights I wonder if I'ma make it till tomorrow, or if I make enough money to take her out of sorrow. But I'm really back and I'm better. Hope your songs came with receipts, cause I'm really taken back by your efforts. I'm playing like I'm down six in the fourth quarter, fourth and inches. 3 seconds left, I can taste the green at the finish. Pray my dreams don't diminish, I can feel my soul burning. Can the water replenish? Mama love me,
mama love me.
Bitches too,
bitches too.
Don't need your opinion, play by my own rules.
My own
I need $1 million, maybe two. Chasing pussy over payment is a rookie move. This ain't spoken word or no poetry. This is heavy artillery on the coldest beats. Stay way to heaven, turn a highway to hell. My life in turmoil, can't you tell?
Can't you tell?
Can't you tell? Can't you tell?
Give on hell, give on hell, give on hell, give on hell, give on hell.
Run from my demons, red blood in my semen. My name paved in the semen. I'm a king and that's notable now. Run my hand through a leaving. She won't forgive me for leaving. They need someone to believe in. Each bar is quotable now. 6 degrees of desperation. I've been waiting, I've been praying. Lord forgive me, I need patience. Living out my grandpa's basement. If I make it to $1 million, will I live to see another? If I don't, just split it with my mother, sister and my brothers. I'm trying to earn my spot in heaven, cause this earth ain't worth it if I don't die a legend. Prophecies from a king, unrecognizable. If you ain't in it for paper, then what you riding for? My cup full of sin and bad decisions. If I make it through the night, I'ma pray for new beginnings. Niggas still can't tell me nothing. Don't take shit from no man, I know they fronting. Yeah, I know they bluffing.
Dilla has been the foundation, not just for Detroit hip-hop, but Detroit, I mean hip-hop as a whole.
you see it.
I'm so full for it.
like melody.
Thank you.
and any tune like the R&B, follow the dawn.
Loving you is not easy, but you're beautiful. It's hard to say no to you. There's no one better than loving you.
I'm not afraid to Ayo, praise to the light peeking through my window. Blew the endo slow, this is my day's intro. Blaze heavenly, heavily to the 70s melodies. I'm mellow G, except in the midst of the ease. Fuck is you telling, I'm ready to hit your melon piece. I'm just defending me, something in my identity. Back to the positive vibes, I'm sky high, flows coasting. Posted by the ocean, gulping potion. Nah, it's the Great Lakes. I'm always floating cause I hate snakes. And levitate over the rat race. And blow haze in your fat face with grace. You misplaced your fate, you control that, so hold that. And always smile like Kodak Black. My flows act like a protractor. Find your angles, it's max the master. Spitting harder than plaster, way too solid to capture. Blast actors for the rapture.
That project, when is that releasing, dude? Get on the mic, man.
Project, some of the beats I played the first half of my set were already on it, so I skipped through it. But that project is just like up in the air right now.
Yo, honestly, I'm not even gonna front. That is some of the rawest.
We did that in 4 days.
That is some of the rawest stuff I've heard in a while, dude.
It's
like,
great.
I'm talking like from beats to the singing. Wow. Just the way that you guys, the tracks that I heard, the way that those tracks were put together, I'm really anticipating this. You've got to keep me in the loop with this project, man. I really want to hear more of that stuff. I was salivating for more, man.
Respect.
Incredible stuff. Sada, I can't say much more, man. You came in here and blew our minds like we thought you would. Thank you so much for coming through. I'm really, really appreciative of you coming through and doing this. And we're going to have you again in here, man, sometime in the near future, man.
Yeah.
No doubt about it. Sounds in here after. This is Pat and Select. Sada, say peace to your people.
Peace.
We're out. We'll do this again real soon. Love y'all. Sounds in here after. Peace.